Okay, now we don't say huden. Okay, now we say hudal. Hold it there, hold it. Hudal. One of the mistakes a lot of people do is they rush off of it. Give it its right. Its right is for you stand on it, then step off of it. That's how they used to tell us. Stand, hudal. Why? There's a rule here that you have to understand about reading Arabic. Okay? In reading Arabic, let's do some transliteration. Woo. You say, I'll say this right here. Say Russ. Okay? In English, if we write that, we would say this, Russ. Okay? Russ. The sound is always emanating the vowel. This is called a vowel, right? The vowels are A, E, I, O, U. Right? Sometimes Y and W too. These are sometimes these. Okay? Alternates, as we say. So, in this word, Russ, the vowel sound, it always animates and originates from the letter on in Arabic now. But I'm trying to show you how we can see that. It always is attached to the previous letter. It has nothing to do with this letter. Okay? This letter can be sukun, or it can have its own vowel. Hence, we should write it like this. Ra. Sa. Ra sa. This, not, they're not together. If this is a vowel like a hamza, okay, then we would have to write it ras a. You understand? It has its own original sound. That's what we have to understand about Arabic in reading it. The vowel sound that's connecting is connected to the previous letter. Has nothing to do with this one. So, a combination sound like Russ, that means the sound, and every sound is given a beat, right? What's the sound of a beat? Oh, I mean, what's the timing of a beat? Open mikdaru beat is opening your finger or? No, you gotta know that so that you know what the rhythm. Alhamdulillah, you see, you're going on a certain beat. Alhamdulillah, you see, lillah, you open up. Alhamdulillahi, you count it off. Rabbil alameen. You understand? Everything has a certain beat to it. So, when I say you step on that letter, then you step off that letter. What I have said is, here we have hudal. Everybody say hudal. So hudal is mushaddad. What does a shadda mean? What is it? Say it out loud, man. To strengthen it, right? So people can't hear you, they like your voice. They be like, yo, who's that guy right there? No. So, it's to strengthen a letter. For us, strengthening a letter is coming to its aid and having another letter just like it, right? Strengthen it with something just like it. So a shadda is equal to two lambs, right? One has a sukun over it. The other one has this vowel, kasra. But we say that by saying this. Because the Arabs love abbreviation. Remember your first lesson? I said you learn those lessons. Those are things that we, serious. We learn those lessons and we apply them. This is the problem that I have with us learning. We learn things and then we don't apply it. It's a rule. Rules are supposed to go all the way through. Attention to what? Details. You can say that in the metaphysical and you can say it in the physical. It still applies. You know what I'm saying? So, here, in order for abbreviation, we just put this little line here. The squiggly line here. And this squiggly line here lets us know that this is two lambs. So step on the first one and say, hudal. How long should it be? One miqdar, right? One timing. And then the second one, li. But since it's the same letter, you hold it as two. So you say, hudalil. You see what I did? I said, hudal, I landed. I have to completely land. My problem here that we're trying to address is that people go, hudalil. They didn't give it no time. Respect the letters, man. Respect everything on there. Ain't nothing on the page for no funny reason. It's there for, to be respected. So we say, Hudalil. And so this one here has to be respected too. So if we go here again, it's Lil. Okay? So there's three lambs. Right? So we would say, Hudalil. You see that? And where do we do that? Not off the tip of our tongue, pushing to the front, like English speakers, on the side of our tongue. When it's on a, over here, we touch the gums very light. Remember your Arabic classes. So it's hudal. You see that? You do it right, not hudal, like la 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 la. No, it's ain't English. This is Arabic. Hudal. You see that? Don't it sound clearer then? You say, well, where did they get that sound? They get the sound by doing their mouths right. Okay? Hudalil. Right, and then go back to it. Hudalil. You hear it? That's why it's crisp. And you hear it. So the person in the salah or the person that's listening, he relaxes. Wow, I hear that. I understand. And they can focus on the meanings of what you're saying. Because that's the objective to recite it, right? Khushur, to remind yourself and to remind those who are in hearing distance to push away the shayateen and to make it easier on the believer. That's why we make it in Islam, the legislation is to let the one who can recite the best to lead the salah. Even if someone might be more knowledgeable, but they recite it in a worse way, then he let the one that can recite it better go ahead. Okay? Because it's easier on the ummah. And encourages them to be in the salah. Everybody wants to pray behind a guy that can recite good. Right? Because they enjoy that. Comes with work. Okay? Use those plugs, man, because that thing's going to go out. Okay. So, hudalil. So we have that there. Here, again, the point is, another point is that now there is no gunnah. And the noon sound that comes right here, because hudan is just exampled, is just like this, right? Hudan. Right? No. That's what this is sound is actually making. Hudan. This is totally X'd out, and we go to the lamb. Hudan. No. Lil. Right? No. So, our examples is milladunna. Nah, that ain't no good. Milladunna. There you go. Hudan lil muttaqin. Muttaqin. With this expression, this double ta here, say nighttime.
Nighttime.
Same thing. You say nighttime. Muttaqin. Same expression. We act like we don't know this stuff. Ta'ammul. Allah tells us, think about it. Don't you afala tudabbiru al-Quran? Don't you think about the Quran? We use these expressions. Nighttime, it's a 2T, right? We put pressure on night and we hardly even hear it. Night, and we press it. Time. Nighttime. Right? Muttaqin. What's different? It's the exact same style of expression. Right? The ta. And do that with every letter in the alphabet. Do that with every sound. And think about the ones that you make. And you'll find, for the most part, we got this. You know? We got this. All right. Can I erase? Can I clean up? Okay. The next one is lam and ra. We're going ra, right? Just two letters today and we're done, right? Lam and ra. وَثَانِ إِدْغَامِ بِغَيْرِ غُنَّ فِي اللَّامِ وَرَا ثُمَّ كَرُّرَنَّ That's an easy lesson. Two lines. I mean, two letters. So let's go on. The second letter is what? What's the second letter?
Ra.
Come on, guys. You should knock me down.
Ra.
What's the next?
Ra.
Right? Ra. Ra. So we say min.
Min.
Min. Min. Hakim is the only guy here. Min.
Min.
Min. Rabbihim.
Rabbihim.
Rabbihim.